Here is a breakthrough. I am nothing in particular. What I am is nothing in particular. This is a wonderfully freeing and enlightening realization. I am nothing in particular. This goes beyond just saying I am just pure awareness. To say it's further than that, you say, I am nothing in particular. I am aware of everything, but I'm nothing in particular. Okay, this is better. I am aware. What I am is awareness of everything. I'm aware of everything, but nothing in particular defines what I am. I am never defined by anything in particular. Whatsoever. This is just an incredible breakthrough. I was sitting in church, not paying attention. And why should I? And this came to me. I am nothing in particular. What I am is nothing in particular. I am, yes, I'm aware of everything, but everything is there, but it doesn't define what I am. I am not defined by anything in particular. Wonderful. Wonderful freedom. Suddenly, there's this realized freedom from everything. Why should you worry about a thing, anything at all? Because nothing in particular defines what we are. At all. Nothing has the capacity to define what we are. We can state this, I am nothing in particular. I am nothing in particular. I am nothing in particular. So, occasionally we will have these breakthroughs where just a little word put in there changes the whole concept and everything clicks. And I felt like, whoa, this is a big one. I am nothing in particular. Yes, there are particular things everywhere, but what I am is not defined by anything in particular. That means the whole totality, everything is there still. We're not doing away with anything. We're just saying that I cannot be defined by anything in particular. What a beautiful state of mind. What a beautiful condition that is. I am not defined by anything in particular. Therefore, you no longer need to be afraid of anything defining what we are. I believe we're afraid. We have fear because we're afraid of being defined by things, by objects, by out there defining us. But when we can realize that we are never defined by anything in particular, then the fear should dissolve. It should dissolve. So this is a wonderful breakthrough. It goes beyond just saying we're consciousness without an object. That's a traditional one. Like Franklin Merrill Wolf said, the highest state is consciousness without an object. But now I'm saying, no, it is that I am not defined by anything in particular. Objects can be there. Consciousness is there. Objects are there. Everything can be exactly as it is. Except there's no definition taking place from anything in particular. So you might say, I am that which is not ever defined by anything in particular. And this is sort of a transcendent concept. It's hard for us to wrap our, you know, to pin it down, isn't it? Because we're not defined by anything in particular. So do we have a definition? Not by anything in particular. So it must be some sort of something that does not lend itself well to explanation of what we are. We cannot really pin it down so well. But however, we can say what we're not. And we are not defined by anything in particular. Most definitely not defined by that. It seems like this is very liberating. And we need something that's very liberating, because the world is truly locked into just horrible polarization and issues that are unsolvable, really. And people imposing their will upon others, and just really incredible, distasteful scenario in the world. And yet we can realize right now, since we're not defined by anything, we don't have to wait for anything, do we? No, I'll tell you what actually happened. I was in church, and the insight came in church that there's nothing, what I am doesn't need anything to happen. What I am doesn't need anything to happen. There's no need for anything to happen for me to be what I am. And that gave this sense of liberation. And then I went to Trader Joe's after church, and walking in Trader Joe's grocery shopping, I suddenly realized I am not defined by anything in particular. So it was a two-step process right there, actually. In church, it was, what I am doesn't need anything, nothing needs to happen for me to be what I am. What I am doesn't need anything to happen. I already am what I am without anything happening. I am what I am without anything happening. And then Trader Joe's was, what I am is not defined by anything in particular. I am not defined by anything in particular. And these just kind of spontaneously arose, just a sort of realization, like, oh, that's right. Sort of like a remembrance. It's kind of like remembering, like something you forgot, like a grocery list. You think you go to Trader Joe's and you're shopping, you say, I forgot something, and suddenly something pops your mind, oh, I needed to get feta cheese or something. And you say, oh, good, I remembered that. And now you feel kind of happy, relaxed, I remember that. It's kind of like that. It's just sitting in church and suddenly I realized I don't need anything at all to happen to be what I am. Nothing needs to happen for me to be what I am. Nothing at all. And so why do I need to wait? Do I need to wait to know what I am? Because nothing needs to happen for me. I already am what I am. I was created as I am. So the stuff that happens doesn't have anything to do with what I am. And then again in Trader Joe's, just simply like remembering, oh, nothing, I'm not defined by anything in particular. What I am is not defined by anything in particular. Just like remembering something you forgot on your grocery list. It's like that. It's like sort of just a simple remembering. Oh yeah, of course, that's right. So there's no bells or whistles or trumpets or anything. It's just like, oh, of course. That slipped my mind somehow. Of course, that's right. It's just like, oh, obviously, of course, I'm not defined by anything in particular. So it's like a mini awakening, you might say. It's just this remembrance, just this easy remembrance that just slips in your mind, just smoothly, just, oh, there it is. Oh, I remember that. Okay. And then there's a little moment by saying, like, wow, hey, I'm glad I remembered that. I'm glad I remembered that. You know, like when you go to market, there's always something that back of your mind, say, I didn't write that down. What was that? What was that? I didn't write it down. I hope I remember it. And then you're going along in the grocery cart and you're getting everything and you say, I still haven't remembered what it is. And then suddenly, oh, I need to get some grapefruit juice or something. That was it. We're out of a Tide or whatever. It's kind of like that. I just said, oh, what I am, it's not ever defined by anything in particular. Nothing in particular defines what I am. And since perception is all about particularness, you could say perception doesn't define what I am. Right? Perception does not define what I am. I'm not defined by perception. I'm not defined by events. Nothing needs to happen for me to be what I am. So it's so casual, this remembrance, that you think, that's nice, but where's the enlightenment, you know, kind of thing. Well, it's just a very casual remembrance. Oh yeah, I remember that. So I don't know. It's what's the next remembrance going to be? Maybe the way that feels. I'll probably just remember how that feels. Oh, that, I remember that. That's how I feel. That's how identity feels. Probably just like that. Just like remembering something that you didn't write down on your grocery list. That simple. I hope so. So it's very important to get this out here, to just showcase how it can be that you remember something so crucial that has just been slipping your mind, somehow it's been slipping your mind, and you can't, and then suddenly there it's there. And say, oh, of course, that fits like a glove, perfect, that's perfect. And I just kept on grocery shopping, and got some blueberries, and even celebrated, got a chocolate cake, which I shouldn't have gotten because it's too rich. that's a rarity, but we're celebrating today because some really great stuff happened today. So just in the midst of your day-to-day activity, you can suddenly, something will just come to mind and remember it and say, oh, that's true, I know that's true, I remember now that's true. What I am cannot be defined by anything in particular. Perception cannot define what I am. So whatever we're experiencing, in other words, we're experiencing awareness, is awareness because it's experiencing. Otherwise, it's a meaningless statement to say, I'm conscious of nothing. You can say, I'm conscious of consciousness, but that's just a circular kind of self-referential definition. It's meaningless. I'm aware of experiencing. There's an experience there. I'm aware of it. But the experience doesn't define identity. Experiences don't define identity. It's the awareness experience that defines identity. But the identity is not defining awareness. Just as the awareness doesn't define the experience and the awareness are one. Nothing and everything are one. But identity is not being defined by anything in particular. So whatever experience we're having, that is, it doesn't define what we are, so to speak. It both does and it doesn't. Because experiencing defines what we are. But particular experience doesn't define what we are. So it seems kind of, in language, it's almost paradoxical or contradictory. What we are, experience is, what we are, because there's awareness experience. Awareness experience is what we are, but no particular experience defines what we are. So we're in a situation now where we feel we're being defined by our experience here. This experience is defining us. That is what we're trying to do. We're trying to learn how to annihilate ourselves so we can be reborn as Prime Creator. And so we are believing that this simulation of time, which is constant dissolution of everything, is dissolving, defines what we are. So we're being defined by something in particular, of this particular impermanence. Our experience is defining what we are. But the truth is, we are never defined by anything in particular. Never defined by anything in particular. Because we're eternal. We're eternal. So how can we be defined by anything in particular? We're not. So from the standpoint of language, it may, what we are may seem to be some mystical or mystifying in terms of trying to put it into words. but we're trying to here. We're sort of looking at it is what we're doing. We're just looking at it. This is the discipline of a spiritual path. If there's something there, you don't quite get, you can look at it. You can look at it, and you can look at it this way, and you can look at it that way. And you're not saying, well, there's a right answer I have to get at this moment. What you're saying is, let's loosen up the ball of yarn here, and let's see if we can just get familiar with the territory first. Get familiar with the territory first before you worry about grabbing hold of a right answer. It's usually once you get familiar with the territory, the right answer just appears of itself. It just arises and says, oh yeah, I remember what the right answer is. What we are is not ever defined by anything in particular, any experience in particular. And yet, there's this, of course, what we are is experiencing. So there is this sort of threshold here where language seems to trip on itself here. So when that happens, when you feel that the language is getting in the way, what do we do? That's where patience comes in. And not try to force it. Don't spin your wheels. Back off a little bit. Back off a little bit. Don't get dug in like spinning wheels in sand. Because definition doesn't have to happen for us to be what we are. We don't need to define ourselves. I think maybe this is a better way to put it. We don't need to define what we are. That feels right. There's the answer. We don't need to define what we are. This is the one that's rocking the boat. We don't need to define what we are. And this really, I can feel that the foundations of are shaking with this one. Because it seems like the what we are doing is trying to define what we are. Everything that we're doing, have been doing for so long, is an attempt to define what we are. And here what's being said is, we don't need to define what we are. What we are doesn't require any definition. That's just like full stop to the mind right now. I don't know what to think next. Yeah, that's like a 180-degree turn. I just realized we are so into trying to define ourselves. We are so into that. And to hear that what we are needs no definition. We don't need to define what we are. That's just, it's like, I don't know what to say or think. Which is fine. Wow. We don't have to view ourselves in terms of any definition. We don't need to be defined. What we are doesn't need to be defined at all. Reality doesn't need a definition. So, when we get to some really insight that shakes our foundation, what do? We just sit quietly, patiently, and say, good, that's great. I appreciate that. That's helpful. I like that. This is like a transcendent sort of declaration, because it's like in the path. We don't have to define ourselves as enlightened, as unenlightened, as having an eye, as having no eyes. What we are requires no definition. It doesn't require any definition at all. including the definition of saying that we... so we might say what we are is never requires a definition. Does that mean it's undefined? It means that it doesn't require a definition. Why do we think of ourselves as something that requires a definition that needs to be defined? The question is, does reality need to be defined? Now, this is a very good question. At this point, I would say, I don't know. I don't know the answer to this. This is a shocker. Does identity need to be defined? When we talk about going into the void or nothingness or something, isn't that from the standpoint of definition that we're talking about? We're saying, I can't see any definition. But the bigger question is, does identity need to be defined? Is what we are, does that need to be defined? Does it need a definition? We're assuming it needs a definition, and we're labeling it as the absence of definition. But does it need to even be defined at all? That is the bigger question. So this question has stunned me, which is fine. I don't have an answer. Which is fine. If we say, I don't have a definition for what I am. But do we need to have a definition for what I am, what we are? Do we need it? Is it necessary, really? Is it necessary? And I would say, I don't know. I don't know. The assumption is that we, what we are is defined. And we're searching for the right definition for what we are. But what if what we are doesn't need to be defined? So we don't need to search for any right definition for what we are. So again, what do we do when we reach this state of just not knowing the answer? I don't know how to respond. Just sit, enjoy it, pay attention, don't struggle, have some faith, have some trust that some sort of resolution will come. Does identity or reality need definition? Huh. That's a true mind blower that just really... So, the only way is to experience these feelings, these breakthroughs for yourself. And so you feel this state of like, wow. And I'm just showing you there is no problem to it. You know, my pulse is the same, my breathing is the same, I feel exactly the same. Everything's just the same, except in some sort of, you know, mental way, some kind of way, I'm. In a different frame of mind, as it were, as far as like, wow, I don't know what to say exactly. It's something, there's a resonance going on, some type of resonance, some type of wow factor is going on. But other than that, everything's, you know, the atmosphere is fine, the weather, the night, everything you know, is the same. It's not a troublesome thing at all. So I'm just feeling like I don't know the answer to this, really. I'm not really sure. What's next? What's next? If what we are doesn't need any definition, what is next? I don't know. But I just have a basic kind of trust in this whole situation that it will go fine. So I'm not like struggling with it or backing away. It's like I'm not like I'm struggling with a wildcat or something. It's like you're walking along and suddenly you notice a giraffe is standing in the distance, right? Pretty close by. There's a giraffe standing there. You say, huh? Well, I guess they've never seen a giraffe before. And never heard of such a thing. And you're walking along and suddenly you see a giraffe and you just, huh? What's that? You don't know what to do. And you just kind of stop and kind of look at the giraffe and say, huh? What's next? I don't know. Should I continue? Should I go away? What? So, you just when you're really working and looking, working at looking, this is what happens. This is what happens. When you really make an effort, this is what happens. You come face to face with something like this, and you say, well, this is the first time I've really come face to face with it. It's a different thing. Like reading books is helpful, but the security of the next line is always there. And so you've got something, your book, and you're reading the page, and oh, let me turn the page, I can go over this, let me go to a different section of the book, I can read some more. But when you're simply looking like this, contemplating, and you really see it, it sort of stops you in your tracks, and there's nothing to grab a hold of. So it's more, it has stronger resonance than studying books. But studying books can be very helpful. But at some point, it's you have to go beyond words, go beyond the books, and come face to face with this recognition, face to face recognition. And it's kind of like, oh my, face to face with this. But it's not jolting or jarring, really. And it kind of gradually sort of deepens on you and says, wow. It's a gentle thing. So it's not something that you should be, you know, afraid of. What I am doesn't need to be defined. I didn't say it can't be defined. I said it doesn't need to be defined. That's a different spin on it, isn't it? It doesn't need any definition. It doesn't require any definition. We can throw definitions at it. But again, it is also nothing in particular defines what we are. And we don't need, what we are doesn't need to be defined. Doesn't need to be defined. Wow. That's just a stunner. Now, if you might read this in a book, you're going along and da 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 da. You say, okay, and what we are doesn't need to be defined, and da 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 da. You say, okay, I get the words there, the sentence, and I go on and on, you know. So I say, finish the paragraph. Okay, I got the page, and I read the chapter. Okay, so good. But again, having this sort of arise as a realization like this, as face to face, it's got a whole different depth to it. And the luxury of doing inquiry is a luxury. Doing it, you can actually spend time just you know, sitting here, being just somewhat flummoxed. You know, just I don't know what to say. Don't know what to think. No words seem to be arising. It's like what we are doesn't need to be defined, doesn't require any definition. What good are words? What good are thoughts? What good are concepts? So this is like ringing a bell. And the great thing about inquiry like this is that when you reach this type of insight, this experience, it's experience. It's okay that you can stop the rest of the stuff. You know, that's why I do free form. I don't have notes. I don't have an outline of what I'm going to say. Because you never know what's suddenly going to emerge, what will emerge. And what emerges can be way more profound than what we expect. And when it does emerge, it really calls for just staying with it. That's why, whereas in a book, the program is already set in stone, isn't it? The pages and the type and everything is already there. So you say, well, I'm just following the path here. And you do keep on going. And you feel like almost an obligation to follow the path of the words. But in this free-form, direct inquiry like this, direct looking, if something like this comes up, I don't have anything else in particular I need to say. I don't have anything planned. I didn't plan to say anything. So you can just stick with it here. No problem. It's a great luxury. This type of inquiry is a great, great luxury. Those who can do this have the greatest wealth, because it's way more luxurious and effective than all the books in the world, where you feel completely okay to simply drop everything else and just this is the only concept there is that I'm even thinking about now. What I am requires no definition. Everything else is just something is just dropped away, and there's no feeling of necessity to entertain anything else at this point. So you just stick with it like that. So there's no goal in looking. There's no set goal. There's not a set goal. It's just look and look and look and see what arises for you. And I've always experienced it's something greater, more profound than I expect emerges in this way. It emerges. This just emerged. Again, I don't know where this is taking me. I really don't. But if there's a feeling like this concept, this clarity is can take me somewhere, as it were, some new place, or some place I've forgotten. So I'm just along for the ride, really. At this point, I just feel like I'm all along for the ride. This idea of what I am requires no definition. It's taking me into new territory. It's like you're driving along a road and suddenly you turn off on another road and you say, whoa, I didn't know that road was there. Where are we going now? I used to do that. I would just get in my truck, gas up, and just start driving with no particular destination in mind whatsoever. That's how I travel. I just take whatever road I could find. As I said, let me take this one, let me take this one. I didn't even have maps. Eventually I did take some maps. I surely didn't have any GPS or anything like that. I would just say, this, where does this road go? Let me try this road. Yeah, that's what I did. And in that way, you just, you know, it's just like incredible. You just have no set itinerary, no time, nothing. Everything is completely open. Let's let whatever happens, happen. And just driving along. And wow, just wow. If you like where you are, you like the road, keep driving. And then you might spot a turnoff or something and say, huh, I wonder where this road goes. And just take that road. And you end up somewhere like you have no idea that such a place even existed. You just say, oh, wow, look at this. That was quite fun. So that's how I, you know, would function. I have no expectations in particular. Those were the good old days, as it were. People are too uptight for that now. They want to know what your goal is. Where are you going? Where are you going? If you said, I got no idea where I'm going, I'm just letting go and whatever happens, happens. You know, people would say, you know, hey, I better call somebody. That's like that. It's a shame. It's a shame. But we can, in looking, it's like that. You just head out on the road, on the highway, gassed up and ready to go, and see what happens. See where you end up. In the good old days, even before then, where you could literally pull over any place you wanted to and just camp. That was before my time. That was my parents' time. Just travel, and when you feel like stopping, you stop. You feel like taking a lunch, you pull over and you take a lunch. Nobody bothers you. You just pull off the side of the road, you see some trees there, you just pull your vehicle as far as you can, get out, walk over, make yourself at home, enjoy your lunch. Then next item, we'll finish with lunch, get back. If you say, well, where are we going to go? Should we go continue on this way? Okay, or this way? Let's just see what we find. Let's see what the road brings to us. That's the marvelous days of traveling, which are gone, really, very much. I mean, but we can still, in inquiry, looking, we can still do that, and we can still just freewheel it. What I am requires no definition. No definition is required. Again, it is just words fail me. We don't have to ascribe some meaning to what we are, some definition of what we are. We don't have to do that. It's not required at all. So, seems to be a sense of freedom with that. Seems to be knocking at the door here. Of course, it doesn't need to be defined as freedom. So, this is a good example of what, in your inquiry, and your looking, of what can happen. And it both is a big deal and isn't a big deal. As both, but there's a balance there. There's a balance there. It's not like anything is. There's no overwhelmingness to the situation, and yet there is It both is and it isn't overwhelming. Both is there. Still able to function fine. It's just a... there's a balance there, and... I can easily just go on with, you know, the rest of the evening and et cetera, et cetera. There's no problem at all. I could just as easily just stay right here and continue with it, too. Nothing feels compelled. There's no compulsion one way or the other, really. I don't need to define what I am. How about that? I don't need to define what I am. I don't need to define what I am. So I guess that when we feel this truth, what we are, and we feel like we might get a little bit jittery, we might say, I don't need to define what I am. It's okay, I don't need to define what I am. Boundaries usually define things, don't they? But we don't need to define what we are. We don't need to find boundaries to what we are. We're not saying there are no boundaries. We're not saying there are boundaries. We just simply don't need to define what we are, either with boundaries or without boundaries. Whether there are boundaries or not doesn't matter. Say we're both with and without boundaries, if you wanted to try to define it. But that's not a definition, is it? So again, the higher declaration is we don't need to define what we are. So this is another game changer. Okay, well, it's getting late, and getting very, very tired these days. Too tired, really. The stress is really severe. Because the demand to define ourselves is becoming so strong in the world. It's always been strong, but right now there's a demand to change our definition of what we are. As if the new definition of what we are is somehow superior, and therefore and is essential and necessary and compulsion, and everyone has to redefine what they are, et cetera, et cetera. And there's this tremendous pressure, deep kind of pressure on us. But this saying is what we are doesn't need to be defined. We don't need any definition. We're not required to define what we are at all. What we are doesn't need any definition. That's a game changer. That's a checkmate situation. By becoming aware of the intense feeling of definition upon myself that is... that the world, you know, that we have asked mind to define what we are, you see. And so all this stuff is, we feel it's a definition of what we are. But to say that what we are doesn't require any definition is just a complete game changer. This is one of the stronger insights that I've ever had, for sure. So, This type of inquiry looking can be done anywhere. Just sit in a chair and just try and clarify what you are as much as possible, and you may find yourself saying, hey, wait a minute, I don't need to clarify what I am. I think the final clarification could be said to be, I don't need to clarify what I am. What I am doesn't require any clarification. It's like I said in the previous video, the Kung Fu master has a stone in their hand. I don't have any stone hand. Well, I have something like this. Can you see that? There's something in the hand. Yeah. It says, this, if you snatch that from my hand, you will have reached what you need to know. Enlightenment. And master always is too quick, you know. And the answer is to simply tell the master, master, I don't need to snatch that from your hand. I don't need to. It's not required. See, that's the answer. So, what we are doesn't need any clarification. No clarification required. There's no definition required. So, we are certainly reaching some very interesting territory here, to say the very least. Gives one pause. It really gives one pause. It's like, there's a pause here. And it's just, on pause. Yeah, I hate the pause, but what we are, we don't need to clarify what we are. We don't need to clarify what we are. What we are doesn't require any clarity, any clarification. It doesn't require any clarification, doesn't require any definition. So again, everything has suddenly been put on a different pedestal. It's just like suddenly they realize that everything is now residing on this insight, and that's holding everything, you know, the whole thing is there. So, big wow factor in this. All right. Whew. What happens next? I don't know. I really don't know. The way things have been going, I wake up at 4 in the morning with some terrible dream. And then spend the next 3 or 4 hours just trying to get a bit of perspective on it and find a way to sidestep it. And so I don't know what's going to happen next. Don't know what the dreams will be. Don't know what will arise from this. It's okay. I'm not really concerned. I'm looking forward to it. You have to be adventurous to take the spiritual path. You have to be adventurous. Fortunately, we all are. You can't be too careful. You have to have a sense of, you know what? I'm just going to go down this road. I don't know what's down that road, but I'm going down that road and I'm going to find out. Freewheeling, so to speak. No GPS, no Google mapping, no satellite view, nothing. You just say, I'm going to go down. I'm going to find out what's there. So, be a little bit adventurous in this way. Be adventurous in this way. This is the great adventure, actually. This is the great adventure. The rest of the stuff in the world, that's chicken scratch, really. It just, the real great adventure is to get these great insights and then because then you don't know what's going to happen next. Really. Truly, that's the real adventure. I mean, when you go down a road, you have some sense. Well, there's the trees, and you know, you got some sense. Right now, I don't know what's going to happen next. I really don't know. Just I don't have a clue. I mean, maybe everything will just continue on as it has, but I don't know that. who knows? Ring a bell like this, you know, what's going to happen? I don't know. But the way things have been going, something is bound to happen. Something is bound to arise, and I don't know what it will be. So this is very adventurous. And maybe that's part of the strain I'm under, is getting to a point where I realize that the tipping point, the checkmate point is being reached. This is checkmate. This is checkmate. What I am doesn't require any clarification. Now that is checkmate. I don't need to snatch the stone from the master's hand. What I am, I don't need anything to happen to be what I am. Nothing at all needs to happen to be what I am. Nothing particular defines what I am. What I am doesn't require any clarification. I don't need any clarification. What I am requires no clarification. Yeah, you know, those are checkmate positions. That's different than a check. It's a checkmate. So once these checkmate positions suddenly all coming into focus, I don't know what's next, really. So again, it requires some intrepidness, really. The path is not for the faint of heart. I mean, it requires intrepidness and adventurousness and a willingness to feel tired and strained and put up with that, because it is a strain. I can feel some shock and some fear and some doubt and not knowing. It's tough to have no idea what's going to happen next. It's tough. So I'll just keep going with routine, my routine. But I don't know what the next, what I am requires no clarity. I don't need, I don't need to work on any clarification or definition. Or anything at all. Nothing at all needs to happen or be done. There's nothing that needs to be done. Nothing needs to be learned. What I am doesn't require any learning. It doesn't need to be learned. So once checkmate arises, what happens next? I don't know. Game's over, and what do? Well, anyway, we'll find out. Pretty amazing stuff going on here for sure. As June is supposed to be. Remember, June is the month of true celebration, realizing that relief is truly on the way. That relief is truly on the way, and so we prepare to accept the relief. So that's why this is coming up now. May was the make or break month. I made it, so I'm celebrating. And part of that celebration is to allow these recognitions to arise, experience them face to face. And then what does that get me ready for to experience face to face? What's the next thing that's going to be face to face? That is the question. What's next? Face to face. What face will I see next? What face will I come face to face with next? Is the question, and I don't know. I don't know. So that's pretty interesting stuff. Stay tuned, because you'll find out here on this channel. Very great. That's it for this one.